Boss, can we kick off by just finding out team news and injury news, more importantly, ahead of the match against St Mirren on Saturday, please?
Yeah, we're probably just waiting on Tom Sowers and Graham Stack at the moment to train this morning and see how they are. Both of them carry a little knock, so we'll wait to see how they train this morning, if they do train. Ian Murray and Danny Galbraith are definitely out. Callum Boot has come back into the training yesterday. It's probably a bit early to include him, so but everyone else should be okay.
Obviously, in our previous two matches, we've scored 6 goals. Prior to that, we've conceded 9-2. How difficult is it to get that balancing act, to get the right team blend?
Yeah, obviously, it's something we've been working on. I think I've said this before, probably out the last 5 games, outside the Celtic game, we've been quite happy. Motherwell, obviously, not happy conceding 4 goals, but I thought the performance merited something out of the game. And the other games, then Aberdeen at home and Kilmarnock at home and away in the Cup, were good performances. So, you know, we're looking to get a little bit of continuity as well. And, you know, it's important that we have people fit that have played last week. You know, we can pick fairly close to the same team again, I suppose. So, I think it's going in the right direction. We're scoring plenty of goals. We need to shore up a little bit the back, which we did last week. And, you know, we're quite pleased with most of it at the moment. There's still a fair bit of work to do.
Obviously a home match on Saturday, but for whatever reason our home record this season, even prior to your appointment, has been far from perhaps satisfactory. What can we do to put that right?
Yeah, I've looked at that. I think over the last couple of seasons the home record hasn't been good enough, so we need to rectify that quickly. You know, there's a few things we can do maybe in the off season in relation to playing at Easter Road to make it more difficult for teams, which we'll look at, but I think in the short term we need to make it a difficult place. I think teams enjoy coming to Easter Road now. It's a fabulous stadium, good big pitch, and teams like coming there, but we've got to make it as hostile as we can for teams, and that starts on the pitch. You know, what happens on the pitch is relevant to what gets the supporters up off their seats and gets them going and agitated a little bit, and that's what we need to do.
How important is it as well to perhaps develop a greater connection between HTC and Easter Road, because the players aren't ever at the stadium apart from on match day, so it's almost unfamiliar to them to some extent. Would you agree with
that?
Yeah,
it can be. You know, you're looking to do things right, which we do with the training ground, and it's important that. But it's also important to know over the years that, like I said this before, teams coming to Easter Road, when it was the old stadium, didn't fancy it too much. It was always a place where they put in their dirty to say that's going to be tricky to get something out. If we need to get it back to that. I think at the end of the season, like I said, that's something to sit down with people and see how we can do that, supporters included, and have a discussion on that. I have a few ideas myself in relation to that. So, but the short term, we've just got to make it as difficult as possible. We've got to go and enjoy it. You know, we've got 7,000, 8,000, 9,000 of our own supporters there. We've got to go and enjoy that and embrace that and get them behind us. I think, you know, from talking to supporters over the last few weeks and some letters we've received, I think they're all happy the way it's gone. But, you know, they think we're going in the right direction. So it's important we buy into that and the players buy into that and get them behind us more